This is Aaron from DB Services, and today we'll be talking about integrating Salesforce Marketing Cloud with your FileMaker system. And the first thing that we'll need to do is set up a new app package through the Salesforce Marketing Cloud setup page. So let's head over there. So first we'll go up here to the corner to select our setup. And then from here, we'll go to apps and go to the installed packages menu. So this lists out our currently installed packages, and then we can add a new one up here in the corner. And I'll just call this one test and give it a description of test. And we want to leave this box checked for create with enhanced functionality. And we'll go ahead and click save. So this has created our app package. Now we just need to add our components. So we'll add component, and we're going to do an API integration. So hit next. And for the integration type, we're going to choose server to server. Hit next. And then these are the different options for the permissions, for the read and write permissions. I'll walk through our setup currently on another screen, so you can view which permissions you'll need. So I'm just going to save this with no permissions for now. So here's the list of permissions that you'll need to set up the Salesforce Marketing Cloud integration with FileMaker. If you want to go ahead and pause the video to take note of these, there are quite a few that you'll need to fill out back on the setup screen. So once you have the app package set up, there are a couple of things you'll need to integrate with FileMaker. These fields down here, you'll need the client ID and the client secret, as well as the authentication base URI and the SOAP base URI. So you want to take note of those, and we'll record those in FileMaker. So we'll go back to FileMaker and enter those in. And then you'll also need your account ID, which you can get from the menu up here. When you hover over this, your account ID will appear here as the MID. So go ahead and copy that and paste it into FileMaker as well. So once we have all of the necessary fields, we can go ahead and get a token. If you dive into the scripts in this file, you can see that Salesforce Marketing Cloud, the authentication is using OAuth 2. So let's go ahead and get a token. So now we have our token. So now we have everything we need to go ahead and download our email sends. We have a couple of test sends ready to download. So I'll go ahead and download those. And with these sends that we're downloading, there's a couple of fields that we're including with them. So we're getting the number sent, the number reached, opens, clicks, bounces, unsubs, and so on. And they show up down here. So as we download the sends, we're parsing through the array, which comes back as XML. And we're using the base elements plugin to parse that array and create separate send records for each object in that array. So we have a couple here you can see that we've downloaded. To get more detailed information about Marketing Cloud sends or email campaigns, you can set up an automated export to export a CSV file, which can then be imported into FileMaker and parsed out to create records. So to do that, you'll have to have an FTP account set up on your Salesforce Marketing Cloud account, which you can find on the user setup under Data Management FTP accounts. So once you get that set up, you'll be ready to set up an automation to export that CSV. So if we go back to home and we go to Journey Builder and go to Automation Studio. So from here, we can set up a new automation to export that CSV of data. So we'll click New Automation. And this is going to be a schedule. So we'll drag schedule into the starting source. And we can configure the schedule to run daily, weekly, and so on. We can also choose the starting date and when to repeat. So first we need to drag a data extract activity onto the canvas, and that will create our first step. From here, if you click choose, you can configure the setup for the data extract, and then click new data extract, and we'll give this a test name here. The file naming pattern is what the file will be called when you export it. So we're just going to call it export zip. And this will be a tracking export. You can click next. So over here on the right, we can select which objects we want to extract. For now, we're just going to leave the default items checked. And then you can also select a range. So if you want it to export the past 1 day or the past 7 days as it goes along, all the way up to the past 90 days. We'll select 7 days for now. So now we have the data extract set up. So the next thing that we'll want to do is drag a file transfer onto the canvas. And that will be our second step. And this step is taking that extract and moving it to the FTP that is set up on our Salesforce Marketing Cloud account. So we can choose that and then create a new file transfer activity. And we'll call this export.zip again. And then for the file action, we'll select move a file from Safehouse. So this transfers the file from Marketing Cloud to that FTP. And again, we'll put our file name in here as export.zip. And the destination will be our exact target FTP that was set up for our account. You can also choose to encrypt the file if you like. So now once we have our automation scheduled and set up, for whichever interval we chose to extract and transfer the file, that file will be moved over to our FTP, which we can then pull into FileMaker and parse out the data of the CSV. And since Salesforce Marketing Cloud uses SFCP as its file transfer protocol, and FileMaker's insert from URL script step doesn't support SFTP, we again will need to use base elements to download the file from our Marketing Cloud FTP and import the CSV into our FileMaker system and parse it out from there. So if you're looking to automatically import email statistics into your FileMaker system, the Salesforce Marketing Cloud API is a great way to do so. And be sure to reach out to us if you need any assistance with integrating Salesforce Marketing Cloud with your FileMaker system.